regards to the children looked after, it's hard when you're looking at the data for foundation stage. What I've told you there is that you've got more looked after children, or had more looked after children in foundation two than we had last year. The percentage that achieved a good level of development has increased to 20%. That's 5 out of 25 children. And clearly what we are looking at now is a strategy to raise the bar in those terms. So the plan, what we've done is the LACES team are working very closely with the school community, and we're doing two things. The first thing is that we look after children, and now this week we'll need to be at one. So the children will be tracked, and the LACES and the school community will be going to each setting where a child is, did not make that good level of development. Because what we need to do is put the foundations in, and we need to make accelerated progress so that we can go to and get back on track. We're not going to do it overnight, but we need to keep those long-term goals to meet. The other thing that's happened over the last 12 months is that there's a more robust PEP and set of targets for children. And I've put in there each school sets targets for the children, for all children, but we were particularly interested in contracting children. And six children set targets to achieve good level of development and move forward. So our initial inquiry will be within the schools where those two children are to find out what we're using this for. So we were trying to put as much foundation support in as we can, and it's quite hard because children come in and out of care at different times, but we're looking at foundation while we're looking at nursery and children in care, so what we can do. And give the best possible chance to achieve the level of development perception. Okay? And that comes to Key Stage 1. Okay. Key Stage 1, percentage of people achieving level 2 in speaking and listening and writing and math has increased. The preschool meal pupils tables has increased in all areas, so that we have half an hour in. The percentage of children looked after achieving levels in speaking and listening, reading, writing, math has increased. It's a good news story. And the focus of the development of Key Stage 1 at level 2, I have put within the report on page 15. And one of the things we're looking at there is to make sure that children have a secure level 2. So if they have a 2C, that means it's not secure, so we're raising the aspiration on the amount of children that get a level 2B. Plus, the real focus is on preschool and the boys. Again, we are looking at for the looked after children. It's been a good news story this year. We want them at a level 2B plus, so that they're much more secure when they're in their key stage 2 and have every possibility of making progress. Key stage 2, again, a good news story. So, preschool meal pupils have attained or more than attained level 4 of reading, writing, and maths. And the preschool meal pupils have increased at a greater rate than the non preschool meal pupils, so it gaps an hour. The looked after children, we've got more achieving reading and writing, however, the attainment maths has decreased a little bit, so again, that's the focus. We're looking at those pupils now that are transferred to secondary school and grade 7 to see what kind of actual support we can give those pupils to make sure they have the best possible chance of getting the highest classes and getting a good education.
Just a couple of questions, if I may. You know, just to go back to the early years, that was a pretty fantastic improvement from 47% to 52%. The only thing that slightly stood out for me was the actual numbers of children seemed to, in 2014, seemed to be slightly.
of children on preschool meals, that's, we've seen a significant change in terms of the benefits that people can apply for and whether they're eligible for preschool meals. That's the change. In terms of...
Actually, we changed it. There were 574 on preschool meals in 2013, but we've got to 2014 and gone down to 432.
Yeah, and that's just the nature of the cohorts. That particular table, which is on page 11, it's really useful when you're speaking, when asking to our teachers, because it's much more powerful when you talk about numbers of children rather than percentages, and that's why I use it. But yes, I can't really comment on that.
So in a sense, it's potentially driving the improvement in the leader. The only other question, if I may, Chair, is just there are a number of the primary schools are moving to academy status. So, in terms of where you've got areas for development and monitoring resources and invasion, what would be the impact of primary schools moving to academy status?
In terms of the Little Country has a statutory duty to support and challenge performance irrespective of whether the schools are happening or not. I have schools for give me a budget for school improvement each year, and there are academies on the school in the schools for, so it's spent supporting some need. So the move to academies will make that much difference. So what we do is for the primaries in July, we do what we call the annual stock take, and we look at all the data, and we band the schools according to the results, irrespective of whether they're an academy or not. So for example, there's a large percentage of our secondary schools were academy, and I'm visiting a lot of them over the next 2 weeks. And part of that is they don't have to invite me in, but we've got a really good relationship, and they want the best for the job. So sometimes children slip back into care. So
Constituency, and also